Are you a business owner who is really good at providing products and services to your clientele, but really struggle at reaching the correct audience with a clear and concise message? Well, if you answered yes to this familiar refrain for countless business owners, then Kyle Porter is really someone you ought to get acquainted with. He's the owner and founder of Guidepost Marketing, a marketing company in Atlanta which helps people refine their messaging so that they can reach the right people and maximize their profits. He joined me this week to discuss his methodology behind his three-frame approach to attacking business and how he uses his own personal story to help people propel themselves to greater heights in the field of business. I'm Kevin McShann. Let's have this conversation. Kyle, if you're ready, I welcome you to the show, and we're excited to talk to you all about marketing this morning. So great to see you, and thank you so much for being here.
Absolutely.
So, Kyle, you say in your bio there that you kind of fell into marketing by accident, and that you were really good at providing services and products, but not so good at marketing it to the masses. So can you just tell me how you got to where you are today and sort of how you developed your marketing and business philosophy?
Sure. So it was partly by accident and partly out of necessity. In 2015, I opened up a kids martial arts facility, and I've been teaching martial arts since I was about 14 or 15 years old. And I had gotten really good at teaching the actual aspects of what I was doing. And I thought that would be enough when I opened my business for the doors to fly wide open and people to just come in and sign up. But that wasn't the case. And what I kind of realized is that I had to develop this entirely new skill set of learning how to market a business, learning how to communicate the value of what I was providing for these families. And then kind of as that evolved, I realized that a lot of business owners are in the same position where they open a business and they're great at what they do. They're great at actually delivering the products and services that they deliver, but they don't really have the tools or the skills to communicate that message in a way that's clear and in a way that's compelling for the people that they want to serve. So I realized that there's this massive market of, just these highly skilled technicians of the businesses that they run. And, and part of the reason people open a business is because they're passionate about what they do. They're passionate about that service or that product, and they want to get it out to people. But, when it actually comes to growing the business and building the business, it's a whole different set of operations that a lot of people can't or don't have the time to learn.
And tell me, what do you think is the key to effective communication and brand marketing as a business?
So what I know is that a lot of people, particularly in the space that I'm in and then with a lot of the businesses that I work with, most people who start businesses are really good at what they do, like I said, and what that means is that they're experts at talking about what they do at a level that's way higher than most consumers are able to understand it. And so there's this thing that, you know, I've heard described as the curse of knowledge. You know, it's where you understand something so well that when you talk about it in a way that people just don't understand. And so the key for me and in the businesses that I've worked with is really just kind of dialing down and making things as simple and as clear as possible, and communicating in a way that doesn't try to be clever. It doesn't try to be cute. It's just focused exclusively and relentlessly on clarity and making sure that you're communicating from the perspective of not just what your business can do, but how your business helps their customers solve their problems and how your business, you know, can provide this transformation in people's lives, because that's what really people are after. You know, the businesses and the services that we provide, those are really just kind of means to an end. They're the brushes that we paint with. And what we're really selling is this, you know, this better life after people do business with us.
Tell me about your marketing company, Guide Post Marketing, and how you help people and your clients that you serve, buddy.
Yeah, so Guidepost is kind of the brainchild of me spending a lot of time working on my own business and then having some success with my own business. And you know, in my community, my local community, a lot of people seeing that my business was successful and people asking, you know, hey, can we grab coffee? What are you doing? And kind of by extension, working with those folks and helping them see some of the same results. And, you know, what came out of that was this process that I developed, you know, where I have now this sort of sequential set of steps that I can take, you know, really any business through to make sure that their message is clear, that they know who their customer is, you know, that they can position themselves effectively in the marketplace with their branding and, you know, how they differentiate themselves from everybody else who provides that service. And then once that message is really clear, once we know who we're talking to and what we have for them and, you know, how we're different and we have kind of the story that we're telling, you know, channeling that into effective marketing. And that means on their websites, it means in email campaigns, it means social media, it means all of these different initiatives that allow that clear message to reach the people that these businesses are trying to reach.
And yeah, you talk about your marketing strategy for people. I know it's a three-step framework. So I'm just going to ask you to expand on that a little bit more. And secondarily, we're going through the pandemic, as you know. So I'm also curious to ask you, how do you think businesses can come out the other side and still be sustainable and profitable once this is over?
Right. So to answer the first question, the process that I have developed is, like you said, it's a three-step process. The first stage of that process is what I call traction. And that is just really getting that message clear, identifying who your customer is, you know, pinpointing the people that you're trying to reach. And the best example for that is with my karate school, we exclusively focused on kids between the ages of 5 and 12. And what that means is, it means that when adults came in looking for, you know, self-defense training or fitness training or things like that, that we told them, hey, look, we don't, you know, we don't serve you. We don't have anything for you. So in that sense, we were losing business from people who were willing to sign up and pay us money. But it was because we were so relentlessly focused that we were able to be successful, because what that focus did for us was it gave us a clear path to where those people are. And what that meant for us was we've got elementary schools in our area, you know, where these kids that we're trying to reach are sitting for, you know, 8 hours a day bored out of their mind. And so we realized because we serve this community and this group of people, it's not enough to just be on Facebook or on Google or on, you know, to have a YouTube channel or on Instagram. What we had to do is we had to actually plug ourselves into these spots in the community where our target customer was already spending time. So we wouldn't have been able to see that with clarity until we hammered down who it was that we were trying to reach. And then the next phase after we have that traction, where we really focus on who it is that we're talking to, what our offers are and our brand positioning, that's what I call the action phase. And the action phase is taking your clear message, knowing who it's being presented to, and deciding really three key parts. Where am I going to live? Meaning, what do my websites look like? What do my social platforms look like? What, you know, what social media platforms am I spending time on? You know, which ones am I going to commit to? For us, you know, there's really no reason, because we're dealing with kids, there's no reason for us to have a really significant LinkedIn profile. You know, we just don't spend any time there. And whereas for my marketing company, that's one of the primary platforms that I use because it's much more of a business to business endeavor. And, you know, and that's where my target customer is spending their time. So once I know my platforms, I develop my sales process. You know, do things happen online? Am I talking to people on the phone? Am I meeting people face to face? And what is, you know, what kind of scripts am I talking about? What are, you know, what are the problems that I'm solving? What are the things that people need to hear in order for them to decide to work with me? And then finally, starting to turn on traffic. You know, am I going to run paid ads? Am I going to do a social media campaign? Am I going to be, you know, am I going to host a podcast? Am I going to do whatever it is that I'm going to do to actually get eyeballs on my business? And that's the action phase, is where do I live? How do I sell it? And how do I get eyeballs on it? And then the last phase is what I call tribe. And the tribe phase is, how do I build a community around my business so that it works better the more people use it? Nobody wants to be the only person in the world with an email address. The more people who use email, the better email works. You know, that's the beauty of Facebook and of Instagram, is that the more people use it, the better the platform is for the users. And so how do I create an entity that, you know, we can build community where, you know, the business owners that I work with are helping each other in creating this tribe. And we've done it with the martial arts school, where we have a community of people who support each other and encourage each other. And, you know, every new person that comes in makes the community better. So that's the final phase. So the three phases, again, are traction, and then action, and then tribe. And that's kind of the process that I take every business through. And with regard to COVID, you know, it has been completely different. But if your fundamental question that you're asking is, how do I solve my customers' problems, then nothing really changes. You know, obviously the way that we had to deliver our service, because we are an in-person business. People come to us for classes. We teach them classes in building. It's a lot of, you know, hand to hand, we're grabbing, we're touching, we're pushing, we're punching, we're kicking, we're doing all those things that we can't do right now. And so we had to shift completely online. You know, we closed down our facility for 6 or 8 weeks. You know, and we did classes on Zoom, and we did private lessons, and we did group classes, and we had online competitions, and we made it fun. And what we realized is, look, people are still going through the same thing. They still need this training. They still need the accountability. They still need the relationship aspect of it. So if the question that you're asking when you're delivering your service, no matter what business you're in, is, what problems do my customers have that I can solve for them? You know, then you kind of have to operate within the circumstances that we're given, you know, in the world right now. And you have to solve those people's problems. And what has been really valuable for us is trying to decide what are we doing that's a result of COVID, you know, that once this is all behind us, that we won't do anymore. But what has this forced us to innovate on? What, you know, also, what has this forced us to, you know, to come up with new solutions that are actually better solutions that we can hang on to and continue to implement, so that our business doesn't just go back to what it was before, but so that we can come out of this, you know, better and stronger with new ideas and new, you know, new services and new ways to serve our clients.
And you talk about innovation, and I'm not sure that you know this, but October is National Disability Employment Awareness Month for people with disabilities. So I'm also curious to get your thoughts on how the marketing space can open up opportunities for people with disabilities to find work.
Yeah, absolutely. So the thing about marketing is really that it's about two things, I believe, above all else. And one of those is empathy. One of those is the ability to put yourself in someone else's position, understand their unique circumstances, and then to deliver things that, you know, that make their life better. And the other thing that, you know, that really makes a big difference and makes somebody good at marketing is the ability to adapt. You know, because we don't see a lot of success the first time out. You know, a lot of marketing is trying something, getting feedback, and then adapting. And for folks with disabilities, there are probably not two skills that people with disabilities are better at than empathy and, you know, putting themselves in other people's shoes, because, you know, because that's something that that they hope they'll receive. You know, they want folks with disabilities want empathy. They want people to understand their position. And at the same time, the other thing they present, you know, these challenges are presented to them every day, and all they do is adapt. You know, and I know that I believe you told me that you have cerebral palsy. Is that correct?
That's correct. Yeah.
And so, you know, you're faced with these challenges day in and day out, and you've got to figure out ways to navigate a world that in a lot of ways is not built for you, you know, and you've got to figure out how to adapt, how to navigate those situations. And so, you know, if I'm bringing somebody on, you know, in my business to write copy or to run, you know, an ad campaign or to work with clients, you know, I can't think of somebody better than someone who is, you know, who is constantly adapting and who's developed that mindset of, we're going to figure out a way to make this work. So, you know, I think that the marketing space is ripe with opportunity, you know, for folks with disabilities.
And my final question for you, I'm going to combine it. Before we started, you told me that you had two kids. So I'm wondering how you're surviving the pandemic as a parent and what you've learned about yourself in that regard. And then just finally, when you're not working, what do you do for fun and to find your own sense of passion and purpose, buddy?
Yeah, so as far as being a parent, the pandemic has been one of the biggest blessings of my life because it forced me to go home. It forced me to be at home, you know, and with my lifestyle and the businesses that I run and, you know, running two, you know, fully operational, busy companies, you know, spare time is hard to come by. And so when the pandemic began, you know, and everything slowed down and everything kind of was grinding to this screeching halt, I was at home and I was spending time with my kids and my businesses slowed down, but it was okay, you know, and that has been a lesson for me that, you know, as my kids are at home or my kids, you know, now are starting to go back to school and, you know, I'm so much more appreciative and so much more intentional about taking time to spend with them, you know, to be around them. And so I think in a lot of ways it's made me better as a parent. It's made me more focused on really demanding that balance in my life. You know, and that's had ripple effects in, you know, in my desire and my ability to pursue my own interests. So, you know, I'm active at, you know, a CrossFit gym. So I go and I work out, you know, with a community of people that I really care about. I'm active in a Brazilian jiu-jitsu gym. So I go and I meet up with friends and do that. You know, so it's been a lot of fun to see, you know, the opportunities that were there all along, but that when you get singularly focused on your business or on, you know, whatever it is that you're focused on, that it's hard to necessarily put those things at the forefront like they should be.
Hey, Kyle, it was really fantastic to spend a few minutes with you to learn about your business and personal life. So I want to thank you for making time in your busy schedule to join me this morning. It's much appreciated. Great to see you. And thanks for the time, buddy.
A lot of fun. I appreciate you having me. Thank you.
Fantastic, Kyle.